Today, let's talk about UVW, which is written on compressors. We'll discuss its full form and what it means. Watch this video completely because it contains very important information. So let's get started and tell you the full form of UVW. So if I directly tell you the full form of UVW, you might not fully understand it and you could get confused about what it means. That's why I'll give you some examples and explain step by step what UVW is all about. If we want to understand UVW, we first need to understand electric transmission. So, what is electric transmission? It refers to the process through which electricity is delivered to your home, office, or any other location. All the wires, poles, and equipment used in this process are part of electric transmission. The cables used in this system are given specific names. In different regions or countries, these cables are referred to differently. For example, in some places, they are called L1, L2, L3, while in others, they might be labeled as SRT or RYB. After this, we will talk about electric motors and compressors, specifically focusing on three-phase DC compressor motors or three-phase AC compressor motors. These are the motors on which UVW are written. Why are these letters written on them? This is what we will clarify for you today. As we explained earlier about electric transmission, the wires are labeled as L1, L2, L3, SRT or RYB to identify them. Similarly, in the case of compressor motors, whether they are DC or AC, the letters UVW are used to identify the motor's connections. This helps us understand the motor's wiring and connections. To help you understand this better, let me give you another example. Suppose I receive a call from a customer saying there's an issue with their air conditioner. That's fine, I know there's a problem. But when I send one of my trainees to check it and they call me back saying, "Sir, there's an issue with the air conditioner," will that make sense to me? No, it won't, because unless they tell me the specific problem or the exact component causing the issue, I can't fully understand it. For example, if the problem is with the blower motor, they need to mention the blower motor specifically. If it's an issue with the compressor, they need to clearly state it's the compressor. So, to differentiate between electricity and motors, and to make communication easier and more understandable, specific labeling is used. This way, when two people are discussing something, even someone standing at a distance can understand what they are talking about. If everything were referred to as L1, L2, L3, it would be confusing, and it wouldn't be clear whether they were talking about electrical cables or motor connections. That's why L1, L2, L3 is used to identify electrical cables, and UVW is used to identify compressor motor connections. This helps make things clear and simplifies communication about what exactly is being discussed. It's important to note that UVW doesn't have a full form. These letters are simply written for identification purposes so that we immediately know the discussion is about compressor motor connections. I hope you found this information helpful and that it will be useful for you. Hopefully, you have understood and learned something new from today's explanation. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.